Hey guys!
Do you know that English is not my first language? In fact, it's also not my second language. So English is my third language after Russian and Ukrainian, and I've been working on it to make myself sound more American for probably as long as I can remember myself. And today I want to share with you my best tips on how you can make yourself sound American as well. So if you're ready, let's go! My name is Radmila, and in 2015, I applied and got accepted to 6 US universities. Eventually, one of them gave me 90% off scholarship, and I went to New York to study law there. So you would think that I have this American accent because I lived in New York for 2 years, when in fact, I had this accent before I ever boarded a plane to New York. So how did I do it? Let me share with you 7 tips on how you can make your accent sound more American. But before I do, please not forget to subscribe and hit the like button so I know that you like this content and I will create so much more. So guys, no more further delay, let's go. I was analyzing my accent and I was trying to break down the most important tips that I could share with you. And I came down to 7 main tips. First tip is that the letter T turns into a D sound, like butter. Second tip is that T is being completely removed. For example, international. Third tip is also in regards to the T sound. It's when T is glottal. You don't really pronounce the T, like button. The fourth tip, also about the T sound, sometimes it's completely silent. For example, listen. There's no T in that word. Tips 5, 6, and 7 are not about T sound. It's assimilation, intrusion, and illusion. And I'm gonna talk about them in a little bit. So let's dive into each of the tips. I'm gonna break them down for you. So when T or double T becomes in between two vowels, sometimes it turns into a D sound. For example, computer is not, you don't say computer, you say computer. So it kind of sounds like a D sound, right? You say not settle, settle, you say settle. It sounds like D in there, right? Settle. Bottle, not bottle, but bottle. Water, not water, right? But water. Heater, not heater, but heater. And letter also sounds like D in there. So now you guys try it with me. Computer, settle, bottle, water, heater, and letter. So beware, the T sound is not always actually T sound. It can also turn into a D, and that's what's gonna make you sound more American. Tip number 2. Sometimes when you actually listen to American speech, you notice that they do not pronounce T at all. So sometimes T just kind of disappears when it's in combination with an N letter. You notice it because T comes right after the N sound, the N letter. So let me show you what I mean. You don't say winter. I mean, you can, but that's not gonna make you sound more American. You say winter. You don't say painting, you say painting, like her paintings are at the gallery. You don't say 20, you say he just turned 20. 20, right? So you kind of drop the T sound. You don't say gigantic, you say gigantic, right? So you, again, kind of omit the T sound. You don't say Toronto, again, you can, but what you would rather say is Toronto, right? So you notice that whenever, sometimes when T comes right after N, you do not really pronounce a T. Same thing with an internet. It's internet, not international, but international, right? So you try it with me once again. Winner, paintings, 20, plenty, gigantic, Toronto, international, internet. Do you see the difference now? Do you sound more American now? The third tip that I noticed so far, it is called glottal T. So it means that you don't really pronounce the T again, but you kind of make this sound like an air is coming out from your mouth, but you don't really pronounce the T. Let me actually show you on the example. So the word button, you don't really say button, button. You don't really say button, you say button, which means that this word now is broken down into two parts, a part but and then mm, because you don't really explicitly pronounce the sound T. So it comes down to button. Same thing with written, eaten, gotten, forgotten, kitten, frightened, rotten, bitten, cotton, Manhattan, important. Do you see the difference now, right? Let's try again. Forgotten, written, eaten, gotten, forgotten, kitten, rotten, bitten, buttons, Manhattan, important. Right? You probably see the difference. The biggest and the hardest part is to actually notice these words in advance, know them in advance, and then practice them on your own. So then you would be able to sound more American whenever you're going to be using those words. Tip number four. As you probably noticed, there are so many rules in American pronunciation which are related to T sound. Have no idea what's the reason, but they're very weird about their T sound. So in tip number four, they're omitting the T sound, right? So they're not pronouncing it at all. Let me show you. Christmas. You don't say Christmas, right? It's kind of being omitted. Christmas. Listen. You don't pronounce the T again. It's listen. There's no T whatsoever. Accept. Accepts. Accept. You don't really enunciate on the T. It is there. You just don't have to pronounce it. Whistle. Again, it's there. You just don't really enunciate on it. Fasten. Like fasten your seatbelt. That's what you would hear on an airplane. Wrestle. Ballet and buffet. Right? So you don't say ballet. You would want to, especially if you're a Russian speaking person, you would want to say ballet, but that's not. You would say ballet and buffet. Again, the power is that you know about these words in advance, and that's how you're prepared in advance not to say them incorrectly and to practice and practice again to pronounce them right to make you sound more American. The fifth tip is called assimilation. This means when two sounds blend together, and I guarantee that you have heard plenty of times about that. Let me give you a good example. It's not don't you, it's don't you. Don't you just call him? Don't you just write an email? It's not won't you, it's won't you. Just won't you do this. It's not I will meet you, it's I'll meet you there. I'll meet you there, right? So it kind of blends together and it becomes this a little bit like a ch sound. The power is in that you do not pronounce every word separately. You kind of blend them together, and that's how you sound more American. You don't say, did you do this, right? Did you do this? You say, did you do this? Did you do this? Did you do this? Would you call me? You don't say it like this. You say, would you call me? Would you call me? And there are plenty of examples like this, but these are the most common ones that I wanted to share with you. So once again, don't you, won't you, meet you, did you, would you. Now do it on your own. Number six, it's called an intrusion. This means that one word is intruding upon the other one, and it kind of also blends together. Let me give you a specific example. It's not he asked, because then it's very clear and specific different words. Americans don't speak like this, right? Because they are speaking much faster than this. So they would say he asked, right? So it's kind of like blended together. She answered. Instead of cutting these two words and saying them so separately, you would say she answered, right? It's like combined, she answered. It's not do it, go and do it. It's do it, do it, right? Do it. It's blended together. It's not go out. It's go out. Go out. It's like one word. It kind of sounds like one word. But once again, let's do it all together. He asked, she answered, do it, do it, go out. Tip number 7, might be quite confusing. Elision means that one sound completely disappears. So why did this happen? It happens that the sound is eaten by the other one. Also, do you hear the difference? The way I say eaten, right? It's not eaten, it's eaten. So, already I'm practicing my own tips. This happens often with T or D sound. For example, next door. You don't really say specifically next door. When you combine these two words together, the T disappears. It becomes next door, next door, next door, right? You don't even hear the T. Or dead, take, like dad is taking something to his work. It's not dead take, it's like dead takes, dead takes, dead takes, right? You hear it. It's not very emphasizing on each specific letter. Or most common, you would say most common, most common, most common, right? No T in there as well. Is he busy? You don't emphasize on he. When you blend these words together, it becomes is he busy, right? Is he busy right now? That these 7 tips kind of helped you look at the American pronunciation a little bit differently. That was actually my goal. American accent doesn't happen overnight. It takes a long time to practice, to repeat after people. Like you're listening to me, just repeat what I'm saying, and that's how you're practicing. It takes a long time to actually memorize the difference between you're used to be saying the words and the way the words are meant to sound in reality. It takes a lot of time and practice, and you shouldn't be discouraged because at this moment, it just doesn't work for you. Spend a month trying to shadow American actors from TV shows or from movies. Just try repeating everything they say. Honestly, this is by far my favorite tip. When I was still in Ukraine, before I went to New York to study there, I was listening to a lot of American TV shows, I was watching a lot of American movies, and I would be repeating everything that the character that I liked the best would be saying. I would be just pausing the TV show and be repeating same thing that he or she would be saying, and I would be trying to say it in the same way as the character was saying this. And if you are impressed by my accent right now, this is basically how I got there. I was just listening to what they were saying, trying to memorize it, trying to write it down the way I am hearing it, and trying to repeat it and use it in my own language or in my own communication with Americans or my foreign friends. So guys, I hope you like this video. If you do, definitely make sure to click the like button and subscribe button so I know that you like it. Also, do you hear the way I'm saying button, right? Not button, but button. So guys, if you liked it, please let me know, comment below which other video you would like me to make, and I will certainly make them very soon. So guys, thank you for watching the video, and I will see you very soon. Bye.